If you upgraded to macOS 13.1 or iPadOS or iOS 16.2 and noticed a new little app floating about and wondered, huh? Then this video is for you. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. This video is all about the Apple Freeform app. Let's go. So first things first, what is Freeform? And no, we're not talking about the TV network. Freeform is a digital whiteboarding app available on iOS, iPadOS, and macOS that launched in December of 2022. This app takes brainstorming and collaboration to the next level. You can jot down and draw out ideas on an infinite canvas and collaborate in real time. So now that we know what the Freeform app is, let's dive into how to use it. And first, let's start by learning how to use Freeform on iPhone and iPad. Luckily for us, using the Freeform app on iPhone or iPad are virtually the same thing, with the exception of iPad supports Apple Pencil, where on iPhone, you're gonna be sketching with your finger. So let's jump into my iPhone for a Freeform tutorial before we go over how to use Freeform on Mac. When you first open the Freeform app on iPhone or iPad, you should have essentially the same whiteboard page layout. If for some reason you don't have a board open, from your All Boards screen, tap on the Create Board icon in the top. It looks exactly like the new Note button you're familiar with in the Notes app. Since we're on iPhone, let's work our way from left to right through the buttons along the bottom of the board. And if you're following along on iPad, no worries, your buttons will just be at the top of your board rather than the bottom. And they're just in a bit of a different order, but they're the exact same buttons, I promise. So on iPhone, in the bottom left is a little sticky note button. Tap that once to add a sticky note to your board. You can double tap on it to add text to the sticky note. So this is really helpful if you want to leave a note for someone that you're collaborating with. And of course, you can adjust the font and formatting of the sticky note from here too if you want. When you are all done, just tap done in the top right. If you want to move the sticky note around, simply tap on it and drag and drop it to where you want. Or with it selected, you can resize it by dragging the blue dots on the corner of the note. If you tap on the note once, you'll have additional options along the bottom. Here you can change the color of the sticky note, adjust the font from here, duplicate the sticky note, delete the note, or if you tap on that three-dot menu icon, you're gonna have all kinds of other options, including adding a description for assistive touch technology. Gotta love these accessibility features. So now let's add some shapes to our board. If you tap on the shapes icon in the bottom, you can add pretty well any shape you can think of. Now, if you don't want to search through all the categories at the top, and there are many, you can use the search feature in the top left to search for the exact shape you want. So maybe I want to add a crown, just tap on the shape you want to add and it'll be added to your board. And just like we learned with the sticky note, you can adjust the size and move it around your board. And if you tap once on it, you can change the color and access all those extra editing features as well. By the way, just tap off of a selected object to bring up your bottom buttons again. Now, the button in the bottom middle of your board is the text button. So this is what you're gonna tap on to add text to your board. Again, you'll double tap to enter the text you want. And the exact same formatting options apply here too, as we saw with the sticky note. We can tap off the text to bring our bottom buttons back, or tap once on the text box to bring up those additional editing features along the bottom. So you can quickly adjust the size of the font here too if you wanted. So I'm actually gonna tap to select the text box, and I want this text to sit at the top of my board above all of the other objects on my board. So remember, because this is an infinite whiteboard, I'm not contained to the constraints of my screen size. Oh no. I can just drag this up above the sticky note here and my board will expand as far as I'm dragging. I mean, you could literally just keep dragging to infinity if you want. But who has time for that? Instead, let's move on to the markup button. The markup button is what you're going to take advantage of if you've got an Apple Pencil and want to sketch out images or ideas in your Freeform app on iPad. Just like you're used to from the markup button, You can select a pen, a marker, a highlighter, or eraser here. And once you've tapped to select a pen or marker, you can tap again to adjust the thickness. And of course, you can adjust the color of the marker here too. Then it's up to you to start freehand writing or sketching if you wish. So again, on iPhone, you're going to be using your finger to do this. And by the way, if you want to move your canvas while you're using the markup tool, just use two fingers to drag that canvas to where you want it. And if you don't like a line you've sketched, you can just tap the undo button in the top left. Or a massive bonus tip for you, if you're working on iPhone and you want to undo or redo something you just undid, all you have to do is shake your phone and tap. Yes, really. I use this feature all the time in my notes app when I accidentally cut text I meant to copy. You're welcome. But back to our Freeform app. Our last button in the bottom right is what you'll tap to add photos or links to your board. So you can either take photos from here, which is so handy, or you can add photos or videos from your camera roll or folders, or even scan documents and add links. They've stuck a lot of options in this last button for us. So I will add a photo of me and my niece from a Habs playoff game in 2021. Was it all a dream? Nope, photos or it didn't happen, right? But you get the point here of all the things you can add to your board and all the ways you can collaborate with others. But before we collaborate, I think it's important to name our board so we're not sharing some untitled board with someone. So from the board itself, tap on the three-dot menu icon near the top right. Here you can rename the board by tapping on rename. So name it whatever makes sense for you. Like maybe it's a project name or client name or whatever works best for your organization. Then just tap on done. Now let's tap on the three-dot menu icon again. Here you can also duplicate this board, favorite it, or export it or print it. But the quickest way to share your board is to tap on the share button at the top. From here you can text it to your collaborators, email it, or even add it to a quick note. A big strength of collaborating with others is that your board can be edited by all the collaborators at the same time, and you will see all the edits that are taking place in real time. Plus, you can start a board, say, on your iPhone, and then pull it up on your iPad to finish it there. And by the way, if you've created a board on one device and it's not showing up on another device, that's because you have to sync your Freeform app. So here's how to sync your Freeform app across your devices. From your settings app, tap on your Apple ID at the top, then tap on iCloud. Underneath apps using iCloud, tap on show more. From here, make sure your Freeform app is toggled on. Now the board we just built on iPhone is available on iPad, where I can not only view it on this screen size instead, but I can edit it from here as well. So maybe I'll move this picture to the right here. Perfecto. So now that you know how to access your Freeform boards across your Apple devices, and you know how Freeform works on iPhone and iPad, let's take a look at how to use Freeform on Mac. When you first open your Freeform app on Mac, things will look pretty well the same as your iPhone and iPad versions, but there are some minor differences here. You can click on the Create New Board button, or double click to open a board you're working on. Now, some of your buttons at the top are the same here, like your sticky note button, text button, and image button. However, when you add text using the text option, there's no need to double click to add text to the text box. You can just simply start typing. Another difference is found in the image add button. You can actually add a sketch from here on Mac as well. And to add something from your folders, that's just moved out to its own button at the top on Mac. Now, just like you can on iPhone and iPad, you can adjust the size of any of your objects on Mac as well by dragging those blue dots in the corners. And with an object selected, you can change the color as well. But the biggest difference is that you obviously can't use your finger or Apple Pencil to sketch on boards on Mac. In fact, as of the publishing of this video, there's no way to even use your computer mouse to sketch on Mac, which is, well, odd to say the least. Maybe that will change in the future, but for now, all you can do is draw lines with the pen tool. To locate the pen tool, click on the shapes button in the top. Here, click on the pen icon in the right. You can double click the points to toggle between straight and curved lines, or you can drag a midpoint of a line to divide it and add a new point. Now, before you get too bummed about not being able to freehand sketch in the Freeform app on Mac, keep in mind that any freehand drawing you do on iPhone or iPad will automatically sync over to your Freeform app on Mac. And to share a Freeform board from Mac, just click on that share icon near the top right. Here, you can message it to someone, mail it, or create an invite link that collaborators can use to join your board. So if you take anything away from this, let it be that Freeform can be a really good additional tool for you to have when it comes to team collaboration, no matter where your teammates are around the world. So you can collaborate in real time on projects. So if you're a visual learner or someone who really likes to hold visual brainstorming sessions, I really think Freeform is a great tool to have. So that's how to use Freeform on Mac, iPhone, and iPad. And now I want to hear from you. Have you used the Freeform app? And if so, what are your favorite features? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Apple content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.